गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अभ्युदय पी यू साइंस कॉलेज मध्य बिहार। ड्यू टू द अनअवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ बोर्ड, जस्ट आई एम डिस्कसिंग ऑल दिस टॉपिक सिलेबस ओके इन पेपर। फ्रॉम टुमारो और फ्रॉम मंडे विल डिस्कस ऑल दोज टॉपिक्स ऑन बोर्ड एंड आई विल डिस्कस अगेन सिलेबस ऑन बोर्ड। बट सी हियर, first PUC chemistry, here 70 marks for the theory syllabus, 30 marks for the practicals, 70 marks for the theory and 30 marks for the practicals. Okay, here in first PUC we have nearly 14 chapters. How many chapters? 14 chapters. Okay, here I will discuss those 14 chapters one by one. Okay, first chapter is some basic concepts in chemistry. Okay, in this chapter we'll discuss about the solutions. Okay, what are solutions? What is molarity? What is normality? What is molality? What is mole fraction? And what is mass? What is atomic number? What is atomic mass? We'll discuss all those topics in this first chapter. And what is the mole? Okay, here all these topics, all what is the stoichiometry? What is the stoichiometric equation? Okay, how to write the molecular formula? Okay, what is molecular formula? What is empirical formula? Okay, here what is atomic number? We'll discuss in this chapter. First chapter, that is some basic concepts in chemistry. The second chapter, structure of an atom. Okay, already in SSLC level, you know about the structure of an atom. Atom is an individual, indivisible particle. Okay, here we have discussed about the structure of an atom. That means atom contains electron, proton, neutron. Okay, here how electron, proton, neutron will arrange in atom. What is the position of electron? What is the position of proton? What is the position of neutron? Okay, in atom, we'll discuss about that particular system. Okay, here we'll discuss about the different atomic theories: Dalton atomic theory, Bohr atomic theory, Rutherford atomic theory. Okay, here J.J. Thomson's atomic model, okay, Planck's quantum theory, quantum numbers, electronic configuration. Okay, here we'll discuss different topics related to structure of an atom. Okay, this is about the second chapter. Then third chapter, classification of elements and periodic properties. Okay, already we know about the elements, how elements were classified based on the different systems, based on the different, okay, different scientist view of scientist will classify elements into different ways. Okay, based on the differentiating electron present in the, okay, outermost orbit, elements classified into S block elements, P block elements, D block elements, F block elements, like that, and transition elements, inner transition elements, okay, and different not elements. Okay, representative elements, we have different classifications, and here, okay, different classifications are there, and based on that classification, Mendeleev, okay, periodic table is there, and here, mostly periodic table, long form of periodic table, different classifications will present in our chemistry. We'll discuss those classifications, okay, in continuation. What are the periodic properties? Well, first we will discuss about the periodicity. Okay, the property which follows periodicity we called as periodic property. What is the meaning of periodicity? The property which is repeated in periodic table. Okay, repeated in periodic table in groups and periods as same. That we called as periodic property. The property which is repeated in groups and periods as same. Okay, that is simply called as periodic properties. That means, for example, okay, take atomic number. Atomic number increases from top to bottom in first group. Okay, increases in left to right in first period. That means it increases in second period, it increases in third period, it increases in fourth period. Okay, atomic number increases in groups top to bottom. That means it second group also it increases, 13th, third group, fourth group, 13th group, 14th group, 15th group, in all groups same. Okay, same property. That means increases only. Okay, that property we called as periodic property. So many periodic properties are there: atomic size, atomic radius, okay, ionization potential, electron affinity, electron gain enthalpy, metallic nature, okay, metallic nature, and electropositivity, non-metallic nature, electronegativity, valency, oxidation state. All those are the important periodic properties. We'll discuss how it varies in groups and periods. What is that particular periodic property and importance of that periodic property, we discuss in continuation of the chapter. Here I am drawing the skeletal structure of periodic table. Skeletal structure. This is a skeletal structure of periodic table. Skeletal structure of periodic table. Here left side S block elements are present. Right side, complete right side, extreme right side of the periodic table, P block elements will present. And in between S and P block elements, we have D block elements. And down of the periodic table, we have the F block elements. This is the just skeletal structure of periodic table. Then third chapter, chemical bonding. Chemical bonding. Already we know about the different chemical bonds present in our chemistry. We have three important chemical bonds. One is ionic bond, covalent bond, and third one, coordinate covalent bond. Third one is the coordinate covalent bond. Here we'll discuss about the characteristics, importance of the ionic bond, characteristics of ionic bond. And uses of ionic compound. How many ionic compounds are present? How many types of ionic compounds will present in chemistry? We'll discuss about that ionic compounds. And here covalent molecules. Covalent molecules formed by the sharing of electrons between two atoms. Coordinate covalent bond. It is also one type of covalent bond, but here electron will share but donate only one atom. In covalent bond, electron donate two atoms and form the bond. But in coordinate covalent bond, electron donate by only one atom and will get the bond and will form the bond. That we call as coordinate covalent bond. Here we'll discuss about the dipole moment, hydrogen bonding, hybridization. It's an important concept for the all levels. Here we have the hybridization. We'll discuss hybridization. And VSEPR theory, valency shell electron pair repulsion theory. VBT, valence bond theory. We'll discuss all these theories in this chapter. This is about the just simple discussion of the chemical bonding. And fifth one, states of matter. What is the matter? What is the definition of matter? Which can occupy and which has the mass? okay, which can occupy the material, which can occupy the space, and which has the mass, we called as matter. Matter exists in, according to your SSLC level, matter exists in only three forms. One is solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. But in our level, okay, here we have the two more important matters are there. Okay, one is already we know solid state, then liquid state, gaseous state. Along with those, okay, plasma state is there, and fifth one is Bose-Einstein state. Bose-Einstein state. Okay, by first we have the solid state. When we'll heat solid state, we'll get the liquid state. When you'll heat the liquid state, okay, then we'll get the gaseous molecule or gaseous state. Okay, gaseous state also converting into plasma state by heating only. Plasma state also converting into Bose-Einstein state by heating only. That means, okay, at Bose-Einstein state, we have the more and more temperature, large amount of temperature. Okay, just here we'll discuss about the ideal gas. Gaseous state is there. Here we'll discuss about the gaseous state and liquid state. In gaseous state, we'll discuss about the ideal gas. What is ideal gas? Okay, what is the real gas? Ideal gas equation, real gas equation. Okay, and here properties of gaseous, and here different principles are there. We'll discuss those principles and problems in this chapter. Liquid state, what is liquid state? How many types of liquid crystals are present? What are the properties of liquids? Okay, we'll discuss about the those liquids and properties of liquid. This is about the states of matter. Okay, then in continuation we'll discuss one more important topic, thermodynamics. Thermodynamics, we'll discuss about the chemical reactions. Okay, chemical reactions under the temperature. What is the relation between temperature and chemical reaction? Okay, here we'll discuss, okay, different topics we'll present in thermodynamics. What is, okay, surroundings, what are surroundings, what is, okay, here, nature, we'll discuss about those, okay, topics in this thermodynamics chapter. Okay, in continuation, then, we'll move into the seventh chapter. Okay, here these two states of matter and thermodynamics, and one more chapter, equilibrium. Okay, here equilibrium, in already we know about the equilibrium symbols like that, just a simple basic. And here in equilibrium we'll discuss about the acid theories, acid base theories. Okay, what is an equilibrium, what are the properties of an equilibrium, okay, what are the characteristics of an equilibrium, how will represent the equilibrium. Okay, different equilibrium constants are there, relation between those constant Kp, Kc, all those are the, okay, here equilibrium constant. We'll discuss about the relation of those Kc and Kp. And here we'll discuss the acid base concept, what are acids, what are bases, and here what is pH. Here we'll discuss pH, what is the meaning of pH, power of hydrogen ion, what are acids, what are bases. Okay, here we have the different acid base theories are there. Okay, Arrhenius acid base theory, Lewis acid base theory, and Brownstein-Lowry acid base theory. We'll discuss all those topics in, okay, the next equilibrium chapter. This is the seventh chapter. This is about the part one. Okay, part one contains, in our first PUC, part one textbook contains, chemistry textbook contains seven chapters. One is some basic concepts in chemistry, structure of an atom, classification of an elements and periodic properties, chemical bonding, Okay, states of matter, in that gaseous state and liquid state. And here thermodynamics, 6. And final one, okay, equilibrium. 7 chapters will present in part 1. Okay, here in part 2, okay, in part 2 we have only inorganic chemistry and organic chemistry. Okay, in part 2, what I said, how many chapters are there? Only 14 chapters. In that first part contains 7 chapter, next part, say part 2, contains okay remaining 7 chapters. Okay, 8th chapter is redox reactions. Redox means reduction and oxidation. Okay, first 3 letters of reduction and first 2 letters of oxidation, then we called redox. That means the reaction which carried out by the reduction and oxidation. We called as redox reactions. What is the meaning of reduction? Addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, gain of electrons, we called as reduction. What is oxidation? Addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen, loss of electrons, we called as oxidation. Okay, here we'll discuss about the redox reaction, types of redox reactions, and here balancing of chemical reactions. Here we will learn balancing of chemical equation and how to identify, how to determine the oxidation state of an atom. What is the meaning of oxidation state? When an atom lose or gain, it gets positive or negative charge. The charge we called as oxidation state. For example, sodium lose 1 electron. What happen? It gets Na plus 1. Okay, chlorine gains 1 electron. Okay, what happened here? Chlorine Cl minus 1. Here Na plus 1 is the oxidation state of sodium. Here Cl minus 1 is oxidation state of chlorine. When an atom lose or gain electron, it gets charge. This charge we called as oxidation state. Okay, how to identify the oxidation state in the molecule of particular element, here will determine. Okay, this is about the first chapter in part 2, redox reactions. Then hydrogen and its compounds. Already we know about the hydrogen is the first element in periodic table. Okay, here its compounds means, okay, what are the sources of hydrogen and compounds of hydrogen. What are the compounds of hydrogen? Water is an important compound of hydrogen. Hydrogen peroxide, deuterium oxide, all those are the important compounds for the hydrogen. Okay, here we'll discuss about the heavy water. What is the heavy water? Hydrogen exists in three isotopic forms. One is hydrogen, we called as protium, H12 we called as deuterium, H13 we called as tritium. Okay, H2O, what is the name of H2O? Okay, H2O is the water. Okay, here H2 means this hydrogen is the protium. Protium means H, atomic number 1, atomic mass also 1. Okay, here H12 means deuterium. This indicate with D, we call instead of H2, if you write D2O, this is called deuterium oxide. The other name for this one is heavy water. Heavy water, and we'll discuss about the heavy water and here normal water, types of water. Okay, soft water is there, hard water is there. What is the meaning of soft water? Okay, which give lather. Okay, which gives the lather with the soap, we called as soft water. The water which not give the lather with heavy lather or lather with the soap, we called as hard water. Okay, hard water, hardness of the water. Okay, it may be of two types: temporary hardness of the water, permanent hardness of the water. Temporary hardness of the water due to the presence of bicarbonates and carbonates. Okay, cation is calcium and magnesium. That means calcium carbonates and calcium bicarbonates. Okay, if present in water, okay, that gives temporary hardness of water. That temporary hardness of water removed by heating only or by using, okay, different methods, by addition of calcium hydroxide like that. Okay, by using those methods, okay, will remove the temporary hardness of water. Okay, what is the permanent hardness of water? If water contains chlorides or sulfates along with the calcium and magnesium, okay, that may be considered as, that may be called hard water. The hard water removed, the hardness of the water, that permanent hardness of the water will remove by using different method. Colgan method is there. Okay, here Colgan method is there, and different anion cation exchange resin methods are there. Okay, by using those methods will remove permanent hardness of the water. Okay, here this is about the one more chapter, hydrogen and its compounds. Then in continuation, okay, 10th chapter is S block elements. S block elements. What are S block elements? If the differentiating electron present in okay, S orbital in outermost orbital of an atom, we called as S block elements. Based on the differentiating electron, okay, elements were classified into four blocks. One is S block, second one is P block, third one is D block, and fourth one is F block. If differentiating electron present in S orbital, what is the meaning of differentiating electron? Lost electron. If the differentiating electron present in S orbital, we called as S block. Okay, present in P orbital, those elements, okay, here called as P block elements. If differentiating electron present in N minus 1 d orbital, we called as D block elements. If differentiating electron present in N minus 2 f orbital, we called as F block elements. Okay, just in this chapter, S block elements, okay, we'll discuss about the first group. What are the first group elements? Hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, francium. All these are the first group elements. Okay, what are the second group elements? Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. These are the second group elements. Okay, in this chapter, we'll discuss about the physical properties, chemical properties, periodic properties of first group and second group elements, along with the some important compounds. Suppose, for example, sodium is there, sodium oxide, okay, sodium hydroxide, sodium carbonate, okay, sodium bicarbonate. Sodium hydroxide, what is the other name for sodium hydroxide? Caustic soda. What is the other name for sodium carbonate? Washing soda. What is the other name for sodium bicarbonate? Okay, here baking soda. Okay, here in second group, we'll discuss about the limestone. Calcium carbonate we called as limestone. calcium oxide, calcium hydroxide. Okay, we'll discuss about those topics. And plaster of Paris, we'll discuss about the plaster of Paris. And cement, here we'll discuss about the cement in second group, cement in S block elements. We'll discuss all those chapters in S block elements. And here, and one more chapter is P block elements. P block element. If differentiating electron present in a p orbital, if differentiating present in a p orbital, those are simply considered as a p block elements. Okay, 13th group in modern periodic table, in long form of periodic table, from 13th group to 18th group elements we called as p block element. Okay, from 13th group to 18th group, how many groups? 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Nearly 6 groups are present in P block. Okay, what are the 13th group elements? Boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. Okay, next, what are the 14th group elements? Carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead. What are the 15th group elements? Nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony. Okay, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. Next, what are the 16th group elements? Oxygen, sulfur. Okay, oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, polonium. Okay, now, next, what are the 17th group elements? Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, astatine. All these are the 17th group elements. What are the 18th group elements? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. All those are the 18th group elements. Okay, here. In P block, in first PVC, we'll discuss about the 13th group and 14th group. Chemical properties, physical properties, and important compounds of 13th group elements and 15th group elements. Carbon oxides is there. Carbonic acid is there. And silicon. What are silanes? What are silicones? What are the properties of silicone? What are the uses of silicone? What are the uses of silanes? Rubber. Silicone, rubber, silicon. We'll discuss about the, all those topics in 13th group and 14th group. Boron. Diborane is there. Diborane, what is the formula of diborane? What is the structure of diborane? What are the preparative methods of diborane? What are the chemical properties of diborane? Boron nitride. We'll discuss about the boron nitride. We'll discuss about the boric acid. In continuation, 13th group and 14th group, we'll discuss all those topics. And here, 15th, 16th, 17th group elements, 18th group also, we'll discuss in second PUC. All those topics we'll discuss in second PUC. This is about the 11th chapter and 12th chapter. 12th chapter is basic concepts in organic chemistry. Organic chemistry and techniques. Basic concepts in organic chemistry means, what is the meaning of organic chemistry? Carbon chemistry, we simply called as organic chemistry. It is a life chemistry. Classification of organic compounds. What are alkanes? In this chapter, we'll discuss about the nomenclature of organic molecules. It is one of the important topic. It is also important for the NEET level. This is the important topic for the NEET level and JEE level. Here we'll discuss about the purification methods of organic compound, and here quantitative analysis and qualitative analysis of organic molecules, organic chemistry. Here we'll discuss all those techniques. Along with those techniques, we'll discuss about the UPSC nomenclature of organic molecules, and basic concepts of carbon chemistry. And in continuation, we'll discuss why we are studying organic chemistry separately. What is the importance of organic chemistry? We'll discuss all those topics in this chapter. Next in 13th chapter is hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbon mean carbon hydrogen compounds we called as hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons. How many hydrocarbons are there? Here number of hydrocarbons are there. But in first PUC we'll discuss about the alkanes. What are the alkanes? Carbon-carbon single bond compounds we called as alkanes. Carbon-carbon single bond compounds we called as alkanes. Second one is alkene. Carbon-carbon double bond compounds we called as alkenes. Carbon-carbon triple bond compounds we called as alkynes. Carbon-carbon triple bond compounds called as alkynes. In first PUC, how many hydrocarbons are there? 3. What are those? One is alkene. Carbon-carbon single bond compounds are called alkene. Carbon-carbon double bond compounds are called alkenes. Carbon-carbon triple bond compounds are called alkynes. Here in this chapter, we'll discuss about the preparation properties of alkane, alkene and alkynes. And last chapter, in first PUC, environmental chemistry. It is related to the environment. What are different layers? Here we'll discuss about the different layers. How many layers are present in atmosphere? What about the ozone layer? What about the oxygen layer? What is the importance of greenhouse gases? What is the global warming effect? What is the greenhouse effect? And we'll discuss what is the biodegradation. What are the types of pollutions? How many types of pollutions? Soil pollution is there. Which chemicals affect on soil? Which chemicals cause the soil pollution? Which chemicals cause the water pollution? Which chemicals cause the noise pollution? And air pollution. We'll discuss all those topics in environmental chemistry. How ozone depletion is observed? What are the acid rains? What are the effects of acid rains? This is about the environmental chemistry and part 2. Part 2 contain how many chapters? 7 chapters. One is redox reactions, hydrogen and its compounds. And here S-block elements and P-block elements, basic concepts in organic chemistry and techniques, qualitative techniques and quantitative techniques, and hydrocarbons. In hydrocarbon, what we'll discuss here? Alkane, alkene and alkyne. Here, what is the 14th chapter and last chapter? Environmental chemistry. How many chapters are there in first PUC? Total 14 chapters. What are those? One is some basic concepts in chemistry. Second one, structure of an atom. Third one, classification of elements and periodic properties. Fourth one, chemical bonding. Fifth one, states of matter. Sixth one, fifth one, states of matter. Sixth one, thermodynamics. Seventh one, equilibrium. And eighth one is redox reactions. Next, ninth one is hydrogen and its compounds. Tenth one is S-block elements. 11th one, P-block elements. 12th one, basic concepts in organic chemistry and techniques. 13th one is hydrocarbons. And 14th one is environmental chemistry. All those 14 chapters present in first PUC. Next, in continuation, we'll discuss some more important topics. In continuation video. For notification, YouTube video notification, please subscribe my YouTube channel and share and like and inform to your friends. Thank you.